الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، ما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ثم أنشأنا من بعدهم قرونا آخرين، ما تسبق من أمة أجلها وما يستأخرون. ثم أرسلنا رسلنا تترى، كلما جاء أمة رسولها كذبوه، فأتبعنا بعضهم بعضا وجعلناهم أحاديث، فبعدا لقوم لا يؤمنون. ثم أرسلنا موسى وأخاه هارون بآياتنا وسلطان مبين إلى فرعون وملئه، فاستكبروا وكانوا قوما عالين. فقالوا أنؤمن لبشرين مثلنا وقومهما لنا عابدون. فكذبوهما فكانوا من المهلكين. ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب لعلهم يهتدون. وجعلنا ابن مريم وأمه آية، وآويناهما إلى ربوة ذات قرار ومعين. صدق الله العظيم، وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. Last night we had read the ayat that after the nation of Hud, Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Aad and Thamud, and then there is many other nations afterwards, all the way up to Bani Israel. So their mention is made here. ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ قُرُونًا آخَرِينَ. Then after them, so the Aad and Thamud, we created another generation. مَا تَسْبِقُ مِنْ أُمَّةٍ أَجَلَهَا وَمَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ. No community can go ahead of their appointed time, nor can they become late. So whatever time Allah has destined for them, when they disbelieve and belie the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not come right away. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appointed a time, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows them time, and at that very exact time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala annihilates them, destroys them, not before, not after. ثُمَّ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا تَتْرَى. After them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent our messengers successively. كُلَّمَا جَاءَ أُمَّةً رَسُولُهَا كَذَّبُوهُ. Whenever its messenger came to a community, they rejected him. فَأَتْبَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ بَعْضًا وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ حَادِيثٍ. So we also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, we also made some of them follow others in destruction. Nabi after Nabi, they kept on belying. Generation after generation, Ummah after Ummah, people after people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept on destroying. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not bother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not get impressed with the increased number of kufr and the number of people who belie the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They choose to go against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah chooses to destroy them at their appointed time, not before, not after, and it does not matter how many or how spread out they are over time. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَحَادِيثٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned them into tales of history. So you do not find any signs of them except that you find about them in tales and in history. فَبُعْدًا لِقَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. So away with the people who do not believe. They will perish, those people who do not believe, they do not inherit the earth. ثم أرسلنا موسى وأخاه هارون. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning about a specific Nabi. Had موسى على نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم وأخاه هارون and his brother هارون بآياتنا, with our signs. And those signs we have read about, that had موسى عليه السلام, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him certain miracles, for example, a عصا and other things. وسلطان مبين, and a clear proof, which was the book. إلى فرعون وملئه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him towards فرعون and his ملا, his advisors. فاستكبروا. So they showed arrogance. وكانوا قوما عالين, and became haughty people. عالين here means arrogant people, haughty people, and also transgressors. And إن فرعون لعلا في الأرض, that means that he was a transgressor and a very cruel person. فقالوا أنؤمن لبشرين مثلنا. They said, just like the others have been mentioned, it has been mentioned that the others also said, shall we believe in two humans who are like ourselves? وَقَوْمُهُمَا لَنَا عَابِدُونَ. And the people that they are coming from, their qawm, their nation, their group, lana abidun, they are basically serving us. So they are coming from a group of slaves. They are already coming from a nation of slaves. So here what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning is that worldly power and worldly authority does not also mean religious power and religious authority. If you have worldly power, someone has worldly power, then that does not mean that government also means that you are on the right side of religion or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. So this is the two things that they said, that they are human beings like us, and even human beings that are coming from slaves. فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا فَكَانُوا مِنَ الْمُهْلَكِينَ. So they rejected both of them and were among those who were destroyed like other people. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ. Afterwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Musa alayhi salatu wasalam the book so that they may take the right path, the Bani Israel. وَجَعَلْنَا ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمَّهُ. And the son of Maryam and his mother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمَّهُ آيَةً. We made both of them a sign. So the mother and the child were a great sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the mother gave birth to a baby without there being a father. So this is a great sign. By birth, Isa alayhi salam and his mother, by giving birth, they were a great sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآوَيْنَاهُمَا إِلَىٰ رَبْوَةً. And about this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala situated them and gave them shelter, إِلَىٰ رَبْوَةً, at a plateau, on a height. ذَاتِ قَرَارٍ وَمَعِينٍ, where they could rest, it had a lot of rest and peace. وَمَعِينٍ, and running water, running springs. قَرَارٍ وَمَعِينٍ, ma'in here means running water. So about this, the Mufassireen have differed, that where is that Rabwa and what is the exact historical background of this. Most Mufassirin have went with the meaning that when Isa alayhi salam was a very little baby, there was a king of that area where he was born, which is Bethlehem. He had, through his foretellers, fortune tellers, learned that Isa alayhi salam is going to get leadership. So he became the enemy of both the baby and the child and tried to kill them. And by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had Maryam ala nabina alayhi salam, she took refuge somewhere else. And that somewhere else, Mufassirin differ. It is probably Egypt or Syria or somewhere else. The Mufassirin have not specified. Different Mufassirin have given different opinions about it. Most have went with Egypt, that it is a plateau. It might also be that plateau where Maryam was situated, where she was doing her itikaf before Hadith Isa was born, as per the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that was a plateau, a higher place, where she had a lot of comfort and rest, and she was protected and secure from the enemy. Wa ma'in, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for her running water. Also, dates and other things have been mentioned by Mufassirin, so where she found everything to survive until that king died, and then she came back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the people who listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pay heed to the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and become obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.